Hi students, welcome to chemistry online classes. In the previous class I discussed about the aromaticity, the continuation part. For monocyclic compound already we discussed. Now polycyclic compound. Polycyclic compound means more than one cyclic ring. If you take, this is naphthalene. This is anthracene. This is phenanthrene. This is pyrene. These compound names I don't know, but like this compound also will ask in the competitive exam purpose. That purpose only given, but these are given in your textbook maybe. So this polycyclic compound, they may show aromaticity or not, we'll discuss now. So what are the our first rule? First rule is it is cyclic. Okay, correct is there. Second one is planar. That is also it's satisfying. Third one is complete delocalization of pi electron. That is nothing but conjugation. So observe here, pi bond, alternate double bond, double bond, single 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 bond, alternate is there. Therefore here complete conjugation or complete delocalization also is there. Then fourth one is 4n plus 2 pi electron, n equal to 2 plus 2. 4 into 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10 pi electron. 10 pi electron is there because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bond. 5 pi bonds mean 5 into 2, 10 pi electron, then it is satisfying. But keep in mind, Haeckel rule is applicable for only monocyclic compound, not for bicyclic or tricyclic. But also here applicable reason that Haeckel rule is applicable for perimeter resonance. Perimeter resonance meaning a outer resonance. This is like this. Pi bond if shifted to here, this pi bond shifted to here, this pi bond shifted to here, this pi bond shifted to here, this is. So this is called perimeter resonance. Like this resonance is present, mean for that Haeckel rule is applicable. Therefore, this naphthalene is aromatic. A mean you know that aromatic. So here also perimeter resonance is there, and here this first rule is applicable, second one also planar, third one is complete conjugation, fourth one is how many pi bonds are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 into 2, 14 pi electron. Then Haeckel numbers 2, 6, 10, 14 are aromatic. Therefore, anthracene is aromatic. This is phenanthrene, naphthalene, anthracene and phenanthrene are having the same number of pi electron. Therefore, this is also aromatic. Then these all here applicable. Next, if you observe here, phenanthrene. Then this is first one is cyclic applicable. Second one planar applicable. Third one is complete conjugation also is there. Fourth one is how many pi electrons are there? Pi bond calculator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 plus 2. 7 plus 1, 8. 8 into 2. How much? 16 pi electron. So expected is 16 pi electron is there, but here this pi bond is not considered here. This pi bond is not considered because Haeckel rule is applicable for only perimeter resonance. Then this perimeter resonance having how many? 7 pi bond, 7 pi bond, therefore 14 pi electron. This is Haeckel number. Therefore, this is aromatic. If you have pi bond present or not present, but also this is aromatic. So this pi bond is not included in this electrons. Therefore, this is aromatic. Very, 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 very important for competitive exams. So now observe here also perimeter resonance is there. Now we'll check this is aromatic or anti-aromatic or non-aromatic. First one rule, cyclic applicable. Second one, planar applicable. Third one, complete conjugation also is there. Then fourth one, how many pi bonds are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 into 2, 10 pi electron. Then 10 pi electron is the Haeckel number. Therefore, this is also aromatic. But it is not completely planar. It is not completely planar, but little planar is there, therefore it is considered as a aromatic. this is and this is same, but pipe bond location is different. After you have 6 member, 6 member, 5 member, 5 member, 5 member, 5 member, but pipe bond location is different. But here there is no complete. First one is what is there? Cyclic. Cyclic is the second one. Planar is there or not? We'll check. Planar means what is required? All carbon should having the sp2 hybridization. But here there is no sp2 hybridization because this carbon is single bonded. Therefore, this is sp3 hybridized carbon. Then planar is missing. Then third one is conjugation missing. Any one of this 1, 2, 3 point is not answering. Mean that is compulsory. Non-aromatic. Okay, these are about the polycyclic. Now we'll discuss about the heterocyclic compounds. Now some heterocyclic compound I want to discuss here. The first one example is, this is known as pyrrole. Now if you consider first one rule, cyclic is it? Second one rule, planar is present or not, we have to check. Double bonded carbon mean compulsory, this is planar. But at this one, if you find out the hybridization, then you will get the sp3. But this is not sp3 because when the molecule is trying to get stability, then it convert into sp2 hybridized carbon, nitrogen. This is sp2 because this lone pair will participate in the delocalization like this. Then this will be sp2 hybridized, complete delocalization also is there. And third one, that is conjugation delocalization. Fourth one is, how many pi electrons are there? 1 pi bond, 2, second pi bond, 2, 2 plus 2, 4. But this lone pair also considered in the conjugation. Therefore, total 6 pi electrons are present. Therefore, this is aromatic. This is aromatic. Similarly, another one is known as furan. Here, total 2 lone pairs are there. In this 2 lone pair, 1 lone pair will be participating in the delocalization, another do not participate in the delocalization because this will be participating in the conjugation. Therefore, this furan is same, all these rules are satisfying, therefore this is also aromatic. Then third one is similar to this oxygen. Now oxygen next element in the group, sulfur. Then this, its name is thiophene. This thiophene also satisfying all this. This lone pair only considering the delocalization, then this is also aromatic. Now consider one more very important. This is 6 member, double bond, double bond, double bond. Here lone pair is present. Now if you consider total, how many electrons are present? 1, 2, 3. 3 into 2, 6 pi electrons. This pi lone pair of electron not calculated here or not considered. Reason, this pi bond itself, these are in the conjugation. These are already in the conjugation. This lone pair do not participate in the conjugation. Therefore, total how many pi electrons are there? 6 pi electrons. All 4 rules are satisfied, but here 6 pi electron, not 8 pi electron. Reason, this lone pair is not participating. Its name is pyridine. This pyridine is aromatic. Clear? Now, if you consider like this one more compound, boron, double bond. Then what you are considering here, these are sp2 carbon, then it is sp2 or not. Meaning here boron atomic number, you know that boron atomic number 5, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Then here outer orbit having 2 electron and here total 1 electron. This electron jump into here, then total how many unpaired electron? 3 unpaired electron. 1 p orbital is empty. So it formed 3 bonds. If this electron comes to here, then total how many? 3 unpaired electron. Therefore, then it formed 3 bond. 1, 2, 3. Another is MTPR butyl is present. MTPR butyl present means that having the conjugation. Therefore, this is also having the first one is cyclic, second one is planar, third one is conjugated, that is also okay. Then fourth one is how many pi electron? 2 pi electrons are there. Therefore, this is aromatic, very, very, very important. Like this, some example I want to give for you. You may be studied in the 13 group element somewhere, that is B3N3H6. Its name borazine, borazine or borazole or inorganic benzene. This is aromatic or not, you have to find out. And another one is, second one example, adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine, uracil, these are present in DNA and this is present in RNA. So all these are present in the DNA, this is present in the DNA, this is present in the RNA. So these are also present in the RNA, AGCU present in the RNA, AGCT present in the DNA. So these are already you may be studying the biology and also you will study in the second year. Therefore, you have to find out these are aromatic or not. These are also heterocyclic compound. So how to find out, already I given. Now one more example I want to give here. This is aromatic or non-aromatic or anti-aromatic. I mean, this is heterocyclic compound. But here, there is no planar. It means sp3 hybridized carbon. Therefore, this is do not following the what you call cyclic. It is okay, but not planar. Therefore, this is non-aromatic. Non-aromatic. If you consider one more example, same double bond and double bond. C or anyone consider here, O only consider, no problem. Okay, here lone pairs are present. Then this one is aromatic or not, how to consider? I mean, first one rule you follow that cyclic, second one is planar, when it is planar, when all are sp2 hybrids. Third one is complete conjugation is present or not. It is complete conjugate because this lone pair comes to here. This will be converted like this. Then this will be converted into double bond, double bond, double bond, O minus. It is look like the benzene type structure or this pyridine type structure. Therefore, complete conjugation is present. Therefore, this is also aromatic 6 pi electron. This pi bond is not considered, which is present in the cyclic ring, that is only considered. Therefore, 6 pi electrons are present, then this is aromatic. This is about the what you call, these all are heterocyclic compounds. All are which one? Heterocyclic compounds. All are heterocyclic compounds. Now we'll discuss about the some ions. Some ions also having the aromatic character. Now we'll discuss about the some ions. The first one is cyclic and positively charged at this one. So already I told you that what is the conjugation, double bond, single bond, next positive charge also present in, that is conjugation, because this having the vacant p orbital. Now only one discussion, one example, p orbital is present in that having the overlapping with this pi bond also. Then conjugation is present. First one rule is it is cyclic, second one is this is planar, third one is conjugation is there, fourth one is 2 pi electrons. How many pi electrons? 1 pi bond means 2 pi electron, then it is aromatic. Therefore, this is aromatic. Next one, we will take the 4 member. In the 4 member, if you take here positive charge, if you take positive charge here there is sp3 carbon. sp3 carbon means this is non-aromatic. Any one of this one is not satisfying means because it is not planar. Second one condition is not satisfying, therefore it is non-planar, non-planar means non-aromatic. But if I want to write here, this is double bond, and here positive charge, then total conjugation is present, because p orbital conjugation is present, then this is aromatic, because two pi electrons. Okay, now if you take this is double bond, negative charge, reason is because of lone pair of electron here. Now if you consider how many electrons are present, 2 and 2 and 2, total 6 pi electrons are present, and complete conjugation also is there, then this is also aromatic. How many electrons are? 6 pi electrons. Then if you consider one more very important, that is, this is the most important compound, pi bond, and here this is called negative charge, is mean that is lone pair. Then how many pi electrons are present? Cyclic. First one rule is satisfied, second one rule is planar. But this generally carbon ions are which one? sp3 hybridized carbon. But also they are in the considering into the planar, because of those compounds are unstable connected to stable, then it is readily converted into planar. Therefore this is planar. Then complete conjugation is there. Then the fourth one, 1, 2 pi bonds, meaning 4 pi electrons, this 2 electron, then it is 6 pi electrons. Therefore this is aromatic. This is called cyclopentadienyl anion or anion. Cyclopentadienyl ion or anion is aromatic, because of this is aromatic due to this 6 pi electron sp3, but also it is converted into and planar. It is very important. Another one is 7 member ring, pi bond here, positive charge, its name tropylium cation. This is anion, this is cation, tropylium cation, 7 member ring. Here positive charge is sp2 hybridization. Then complete conjugation is the first one, cyclic, second one planar, third one conjugation, fourth one is 1, 2, 3 mean 3 into 2, 6 pi electrons. Therefore this is aromatic. These are very important for competitive exam. So I hope I clearly explained about the aromaticity. Maximum examples are given. Some other example also is there that you have to read from any other book. But maximum examples are I given for each one type. First one is a monocyclic, second one polycyclic, next one is a heterocyclic, next one is ion. These are ions that may be positively charged ions or negatively charged ion. These are aromatic. Okay, but some other example also we may consider as an aromatic reason. See, this is like this, pi bond and here pi bond. This is aromatic or not, mean what you will consider is cyclic, but here outside the ring is pi bond, inside not there. Here how many are there? 1, 2 bonds are there. 2 bond mean 4 pi electron. Here how many are there? 2 pi electron. But outside pi bond is there, mean this is aromatic or not, you will get the confusion. But see, this one we know that if negative charge is present, that is aromatic. If positive charge is present, that is aromatic. Then this we move like this. Then this will get the negative charge, this will get the positive. Overall this is aromatic. Because this half part also aromatic, this half part also aromatic when pi bond shifted like this. Similarly, now one is 5 member ring, another is 7 member ring. This is 7 member ring, this is 5 member ring, and here positive double bond. Then these are aromatic or not, mean already we know this is negatively charged aromatic, this positively charged aromatic, mean now pi bond move towards this 5 member ring. This will be converted to negative, this will be converted to positive. Here this will be converted to negative, this will be converted to positive. Overall these are aromatic. So like this we have to consider. And one more example I want to give here. Now this is pi bond, pi bond, pi bond, and outside one pi bond is there. Then what you will consider inside the ring pi bond only we have to consider, outside the pi bond no need to consider, because this is 6 pi electron system, then it is aromatic, but don't consider this one. So these are very very good example, you have to remember or practice each and everything. Now I want to discuss about the preparation of benzene. The first one is commercial preparation. Commercial preparation of benzene is from coal tar. This much only given in your textbook. You have to remember this is from commercial preparation, means large amount to prepare benzene. We have to use coal tar. From coal tar, we will get the benzene. Then, second one method already we studied from alkyne. From alkyne. From alkyne, otherwise, this is known as a cyclic polymerization of ethyne. Cyclic polymerization of ethyne. Now already we know that 3 moles of HC triple bond CH, this is known as the ethyne. This ethyne red hot tube, red hot iron tube or copper tube, nearly 873 Kelvin temperature, then this will be converted into benzene. So this is already shown like this. This is a triple bond one, and this is another triple bond, mean ethyne. This is also ethyne. This will be more like this. This will be more like this. This is like, then it form benzene ring. This is one of the preparation. Then fourth one. Sorry, this third only, because this is 3 moles, not this one. So now this is first, this is second, this is third one. This is from benzoic acid derivative, that is called sodium benzoate. This is known as COONa, this is known as sodium benzoate. This already you know that decarboxylation. What is the decarboxylating agent? That is soda lime, NaOH and calcium oxide. This mixture is known as the soda lime. Then you will get here benzene, double bond, double bond, double bond, and it form Na2CO3. So these are the preparation method for benzene. Another one important one is reduction of phenol. This is a fourth method, reduction. Now consider this is a phenol. This phenol on heating with the zinc dust, or you can add zinc also and heat symbol. On heating with the zinc dust, you will get the benzene. This H will be shifted here and total C6H6. This zinc and this oxygen form zinc oxide. So this is a preparation method for benzene. Okay, next we will discuss about the properties. Now the physical properties, because in properties we have the two. One is physical properties, next chemical properties. So first I want to discuss about the physical properties. Already I told you that for every chapter, first we have to discuss about the physical state, their characteristic smells, and what do you call their solubility, then boiling point, melting point if it is present. So first one is these compounds, it means benzene or benzene derivatives, are non-polar. When these are non-polar, it may be in the solid or in liquid state. These are maybe solid or liquid with the characteristic smell. You are well known about the example naphthalene. Naphthalene used one. Naphthalene used in one. In toilets, already in is there, therefore I have written in toilets. Because it having a characteristic smell. Because of smell. Second one, preservation of clothes because of moth repelling character. Then these are the some uses of naphthalene. You know, you maybe know that this is naphthalene is nothing but Damar Goli. These are naphthalene balls. These are also in the different colors also. Generally, this is white color. And then third one, solubility. Already I told you that these are the non-polar. Non-polar means these are soluble in the organic solvent. Organic solvents are generally non-polar. Therefore, these are soluble. It means benzene derivatives are soluble in organic solvents, but insoluble. Otherwise, in your textbook, maybe soluble word they removed and maybe given miscible. See, this is miscible. So, our benzene or benzene derivatives are miscible in organic solvent, but immiscible in water. Immiscible, generally miscible, immiscible word used for solvent. It means liquid type. Miscible means soluble type, immiscible means insoluble type. So organic compound or this benzene derivatives are immiscible in water, means they are not soluble in water because of they are non-polar. Water is polar. And boiling point discussion not there in your textbook. Anyway, you know that mass increases, their boiling point increases. So successive member of their homologous series, their boiling point will be increased. Here branches not there because these are cyclic compound, therefore generally these are when molar mass increases, their boiling point will be increases. These are the physical properties. Next we will discuss about the chemical properties. Now the chemical properties are chemical properties. How to identify this chemical property? These undergo electrophilic substitution or electrophilic addition reaction. Already told you that aromatic compound having a special character that will undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. This will be denoted like this as E. This is given in your textbook also. Its meaning, what is that? Electrophilic substitution reaction. This benzene undergo or benzene derivative will undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Under normal condition do not undergo addition reaction. Under normal condition do not undergo addition reaction, but at special conditions, that is at high temperature or high pressure condition, it undergo or benzene derivative undergo addition reaction and also oxidation reaction. So keep in mind, generally this benzene and benzene derivative will undergo which type of reaction? Electrophilic substitution reaction. This is very 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 important. Why it undergo electrophilic substitution reaction rather than this addition reaction? Mean if you take this benzene for addition reaction, this is double bond, double bond, double bond, then bromine in CCl4, if it undergo addition reaction, then here bromine, 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 then it lost its aromatic character. How to decide aromatic character? Cyclic, planarity missing because these are sp3 carbon, complete conjugation also missing, therefore it is non-aromatic. The same reaction if it is carried out, double bond, and here bromine in presence of any Lewis acid like this FeBr3, then it undergoes substitution because every corner one hydrogen is there. So to indicate substitution reaction, that purpose I am writing here one hydrogen. This hydrogen replaced by this bromine, then here bromine. One hydrogen, one Br, this is HBr. Now if you consider cyclic is there, complete conjugation, planarity is there and 6 pi electron is there, then this is aromatic, this is non-aromatic. Therefore, these will undergo which type of reaction? Aromatic, electrophilic substitution reaction, but not the addition reaction. Under special condition only, these will undergo addition or oxidation reaction. So this is why aromatic compound undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Also, it is known as an aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction.